Hey guys, hope you are all having a great day. Today we traded pretty much in line as predicted yesterday. Nothing huge happened today, so we are going to go over some small important developments. Before we start, let me quickly state that I am not a financial advisor, and that all content discussed in this channel is simply information gathered that I deem important for people to know, so that they can make informed decisions. All efforts are aimed to better understand the nature of the current market in anticipation of the greatest squeeze in financial history. Let's get started. The Fed announced that the Vice Chair Richard Clarida will be stepping down from the central bank on Friday, 2 weeks earlier than his term was scheduled to end, in the wake of the allegations made in regards to his trading activity at the onset of the pandemic. Last month, Clarida quietly admitted that he failed to fully disclose financial trade in February of 2020, with this revelation being just the latest of a full string of ethical problems that the central bank has. The Fed official came under fire after being caught moving between $1 million and $5 million out of a bond fund into a stock fund on February of 2020. That was just a day before Jerome Powell signaled that the central bank was going to move to cushion the economy when the pandemic hit the US. Clarida said he sold between $1 million and $5 million in the same stock fund 3 days prior to buying it, indicating that he was actively trading. Lael Brainard has been tapped to replace Clarida as vice chair, and will be having her hearing on Thursday. The stock market resumed its sell-off today as government bond yields moved upwards, foreshadowing that traders think it is more likely that the Federal Reserve will raise interest rates in the next few months. Remember, the Fed has two main jobs: maximizing employment and keeping prices stable. The Fed typically adjusts short-term interest rates to keep inflation around 2% and cut unemployment as much as possible. When the Fed determines the economy is close to full employment, it hikes interest rates to make it tougher for firms to borrow and to keep a lid on spending that drives price increases. The Labor Department said the price consumers pay for goods rose more than 6% in November, with hot inflation all but guaranteeing the Fed rate hikes coming relatively soon. Knowing this, remember that Jerome Powell will be going to Congress tomorrow to tell Congress what steps the central bank will be taking to ensure higher inflation is contained, and to assure then these steps will ensure higher inflation will not be allowed to develop deep roots in the economy. Jerome was quoted saying that they are using their tools to support the economy and a strong labor market and to prevent higher inflation from becoming entrenched. Lastly, let's update you guys on the situation happening with Evergrande. China's infamous property developer has seen a lot of drama today after reports suggest that they are attempting to avoid yet another high-profile default, since they have no money to pay its investors for the next round of interest payments. Today they said in a filing that the voting period for bondholders' meeting will be extended to January 13. Furthermore, today Evergrande began removing its name from its corporate headquarters in Shenzhen. Three of the four Chinese characters in the company's name had been taken down, with only the letter ever remaining in its English name. The company said they moved to a building it owns elsewhere in Shenzhen to save on rent amid its cash crunch. Today, Hengda Real Estate Group, Evergrande's main domestic operating subsidiary, closed a four-day online meeting in which holders of $706 million in domestic bonds voted on whether to push back the next interest payment on the three-year bond from Monday. If this proposal passes, it would delay bondholders' first chance to demand the company pay off its debt early. The results of the vote are still unknown, so we await news on this subject. I will continue to monitor the situation and update you guys as things continue to get rocky for China. Let's now talk about today. The Fed submitted over $1.560 trillion in reverse repo operations today. Dark pool trades for AMC accounted for 54% of the total volume today, while dark pool trades for GameStop accounted for 47% of the total volume today. AMC had a larger amount of buy orders than its sell orders, with GameStop also having a larger amount of buy orders than sell orders. Now, let's talk about performance. AMC traded bearishly, losing under 1% today. It began trading bearishly during the pre-market, continually breaking support for pretty much the entirety of the pre-market. It was only close to market opening that AMC was allowed to bounce up a bit, going from 22.10 to 22.30, which was pretty insignificant considering that it then continued to fall. Upon market opening, AMC bounced to 22.50, only to fall back down and reach 21.30. AMC would move up, showing a lot of volatility. It had a hard time breaking above 21.90 initially, but managed to do so, reaching 22.10. However, it was unable to hold or consolidate above this price, so it fell back down to 21.50, where it kept trying to break above the VWAP. After a small period of time, AMC broke past the VWAP, and actually ran past 22.30 again, but that is when shorters really dipped AMC, bringing it down to 21.25 again. After a couple minutes, AMC bounced up again, this time reaching 22.30 once again. After a small retracement, it ran up and actually broke past this resistance wall to 22.50. It then continued to fall, breaking support at the VWAP and instead consolidating a bit at 21.50. AMC then ran up again, breaking past the VWAP resistance at 21.80 and continued running upwards to 22.20. Here, AMC would find some difficulty breaking the resistance, but would eventually do so, once again running and testing the upper band of VWAP, especially during those last couple of minutes. AMC reached a high of 22.87 during normal trading hours before dipping and closing at a price of 22.78, above the VWAP. As for what to expect tomorrow, AMC will find support at 21, 22 and 22.44. Resistance will be met at 23, 23.28 and 24. AMC had a very hard fall today, which it started recovering, but like I said yesterday, what will allow it to truly continue moving upwards are the news coming from the Fed on Wednesday. Depending on how that goes, we could retest 20 or continue moving upwards to eventually pass 24.64 once again. I think tomorrow will be similar to today in the sense that we continue to trade between 21 and 23 in anticipation for the Fed hearing on Wednesday. GameStop traded bearishly, losing over 6%. GameStop was breaking support during the pre-market, falling from 139 to 133. It made a big attempt to run and stay above the VWAP, but shorters ensured weakness by beating the beloved stock below it and keeping it there. As we neared market opening, GameStop starting moving upwards, testing the VWAP and finally breaking above it, if only momentarily. Once the markets opened, GameStop ran past 135 before falling down, finding support above 126 for the most part. Here, it attempted to test the VWAP at one point but was unable to break it, so it retraced back to 126. After a short bit, GameStop slid again, this time reaching 120 as support. It quickly bounced up, testing 124 as resistance now, but shorters made sure to drag GME down one more time, once again testing the 120 support wall. Once here, it began moving upwards, this time reaching the VWAP and breaking it momentarily. It retraced underneath it again but then bounced up, breaking above it. GameStop found some good momentum, which allowed it to further break more resistance, this time testing 128. It then moved up again past 129 and consolidated on this price for a while before retracing back down under 127. After a small period, GameStop rallied and ran upwards, breaking the 130 resistance wall and closing at 131.15, above the VWAP. As for what to expect tomorrow, GameStop will find support at 126, 124 and 120. Resistance will be met at 131, 137 and 140. GameStop had a pretty steep fall this morning, but through the rest of the day it would continue to recover. As you can see in the 20-day chart, we did a double bottom, and though I would love for GameStop to find higher ground immediately, this uncertain market will most likely have it trading between 130 and 120 tomorrow. Already in the after hours, GameStop has been falling down, which means this little bounce we experienced during the alter half of the day could be easily undone tomorrow. Those that haven't bought the dip might be granted a third opportunity to hope on in. And that is all I have for you guys today. Some questions I have been getting are, when am I going to make the Discord for day trading alerts? I will be working on that this week. I have been busy with some family visits, so I have had no time to get all that set up. As soon as I have it ready, I will make a community announcement here on YouTube and also on Twitter, so be sure to follow me on both. Sorry for the delay of this video, I encountered a serious problem and it took me a while to fix it. I was day trading some momentum stocks and my order was not filled by my broker and I got caught holding a bag which I refused to sell at a loss because of a technical error by my broker, and it took me a while to chart and prepare for what's next in that play, which took me around an hour, hence the timely delay for today. I got all that settled, so don't worry about it. Thank you all for watching my video to its end, really appreciate you guys a ton for sticking by this channel. If you want to support this channel, I have a Patreon link in the description as well as some one-time donation links for Cash App and PayPal. Thank you again for being a part of this channel. I will continue striving for better content. Enjoy the rest of your day. Keep on buying the dip into the moon.